Hi. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. This song was experienced by my family when we were living in northern Alberta. And we came down to California for about 3 weeks. Our youngest and oldest came with us. And our oldest was a little nervous. So instead, we brought a CD player with us, with a CD, that had this song on it. And every night, she'd go to sleep listening to the song. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. And we were in California. And in California, we had a lot of fun. Went to Disneyland, saw the beach, visited all our family and friends. And then we came back to Canada. Now, bear in mind, we were in northern Alberta. And so, with northern Alberta, you had to drive 4 hours to the airport, spend the night in the hotel, and the next day fly back. Same thing going back home. And so, when we got to the airport of Edmonton, all of our luggage was there. But our car seats were not. We were stuck in the airport with 2 toddlers and no safe way of driving them 4 hours north to High Prairie, Alberta. We were mad. We were upset. Also, the problem was the airline sent a person there to apologize, but they didn't have our car seats. They just had vouchers for hotel and some restaurants and lots and lots of I'm sorries. So I dealt with the person and got the stuff. We got into a shuttle to the hotel, all with the flight attendants and the crew from the airplane that got us there. We were really, really upset. Mad. And as we got in the shuttle, and we were in front of the hotel that was going to get us to our place until we waited for the car seats, our eldest daughter looked up at me, eyes as wide as moons, smiling, and asked, "Dad, is this the time we're going to rejoice in the Lord always?" And I looked back at her and said, "Who told you that? Where'd you get that from? Seriously." And she was looking back at me, eyes wide, and with a smile. See, for her, that song put her to bed every night, made her feel safe, and now she wanted to find out if it was true, or was it just a song? Should we rejoice in the Lord always? Was the Bible true? Was God doing a work in our lives every day? Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. And I sing this song as an encouragement to us in our season. Rejoice in the Lord always. Is that just something we sang before COVID-19? Is that something that we're hoping to sing after COVID-19, when everything is back to normal? Or is it a song we sing now?